everybody had had to be separated. And Emma had ended up in the bedsit. We couldn't put Emma back into the house until we were absolutely sure that that house was calm enough for Emma and Victor to be in the same room.
That never happened, and Emma had to go.
I suppose I felt bad in a way for her because we were partially responsible for that, because we put her in a room and we kind of tortured her with knowledge of what her housemates thought of her. And somebody said to me, if you knew what your best friend said about you behind your back, you wouldn't have any friends. And I think that was the case in the bedsit. Suddenly they could see everything that everyone was saying, and it was really painful.
Series 5 had set out to take everything to its limits. It succeeded, but in some people's eyes, Big Brother would never be the same again.
Series 5 changed everything for Big Brother because it became something that needed to be contained rather than something that needed to be let go.
By 2006, Big Brother had reached its halfway point, and some members of the team began moonlighting.
I went and did my chat show, and it went really, really badly.
It absolutely knocked her confidence, and who wouldn't have been knocked by the flack that Davina got for that unfairly?
It was crippling. It was crippling. You know, I had like 2-3 months of really feeling really down and thinking, my career's over. You know, this is it. I'm finished. And then I went back to Big Brother and I thought, God, I'm not finished. I was welling up as I walked out to the crowd before we went live.
This show would not be Big Brother if we didn't have her at the top.
I'm going to start crying. Don't be nice to me. Thank you.
I suddenly thought, God, these people still love Big Brother and they still want me to present it and it's all going to be okay. And that was a very moving feeling.
Series 7 was bright, colourful and cartoonish, and its decibels boosted by a new kind of housemate.
Who is she?
When I first entered Big Brother, I was going through this weird phase in my life of going out to the clubs like China White's and Faces in Essex and just living this lifestyle which was totally false.
Nikki was almost too hyper to be real. When she was voted out, some said good riddance, but not the producers.
We were getting to the last 4 weeks and it was running out of steam because it just did. I was thinking, what can we do over the next 4 weeks? I know, why don't we vote some people back in? So I presented this idea to the execs, who, bless them at the time, said, you're making a massive mistake. We don't want to do this. And I persuaded them to do it.
Nikki, you have been chosen to return to the Big Brother house for the final week.
That's the one moment Big Brother did mess up.
I think it upset quite a lot of people, and a lot of people suddenly sat up and said, you know, we paid a lot of money to get Nikki out of that house. Why are you putting her back in?
That's the one unspoken rule between producers and public. You get to choose who stays in and who doesn't. So the fact that when she went back in, that unwritten rule was kind of broken.
For some people, it isn't just a call. You know, some people it's 20 calls, so I completely get that you'd be very annoyed that, you know, you spent 10 quid on trying to get Nikki out, and then what do? We go and chuck her back in again.
It was entirely my idea, and I've had some good ideas in my time. I hope people will recognise, but I've had some bad ideas, and that was a particularly bad one.
I would define celebrity that people on the street recognise you. Full stop, Herb Bateman.
Big Brother was now a no-holds-barred entertainment experience, still pulling in audiences and inspiring dreams of fame and fortune for lines of wannabe housemates.
In the kind of second half of the decade, you'd get the kind of open auditions, you'd get more kind of wannabes, you'd get people who'd film themselves showing off.
They knew how the audition process worked, and so, you know, they came almost prepared.
If you want entertainment, then you've got to put the tassel in it.
People want to be famous, and so they see Big Brother as a vehicle to fame.
I want attention, I love attention, and I'm up for a challenge.
And we think we're more fun than everybody else.
Definitely.
Before you know it, you've got 12 quite fame-hungry people that, you know, have got an idea that they're talented. Well, we don't want talented people, we just want good characters.
I watch Big Brother like everybody else at home. However, if I'm honest, I tend to watch it through business goggles. To give you an example, somebody like Chanel, from the minute she got out of the car, I saw this girl that looked like Victoria Beckham, dressed like Victoria Beckham. I've got pound signs ringing in my eyes within 8 seconds of seeing this girl on television. And then, of course, she hit the big rollover jackpot, if you like, because she started to do the most important thing you do in the Big Brother house, which is develop a relationship. You add in extra zeros to the end of every cell. You come out of the Big Brother house, you're going to be on the next day's cover of the newspapers, the following day's glossy magazines, then you're going into your own lifestyle. Do we write a book? Do we release a calendar for next year? Do we release an aftershave? Tend to just go for everything because you're trying to bank the most amount of money in a very small amount of time. I have to be careful not to sound like a hypocrite on this question because I don't necessarily respect the celebrity culture we live in. You know, we should be saying you work hard, you get qualifications, you get a good job and you can have a good successful life. The unfortunate flip side of that is I think Big Brother give this sense that you can do it on the cheap. So I'm not a big fan.
Coming up, what it feels like when the world falls in on Big Brother.
It was a horrible, horrible afternoon.
By 2007, British Big Brother had outlived the original Dutch version by a year. As always, Summer BB was to be followed by the shorter, less intense celebrity version in the new year.
OK, hello and welcome to Celebrity Big Brother 2007!
The thing about Celebrity Big Brother is you always did it going, it's a three-week run, it'll be pretty fun, we'll have a bit of a laugh. We all see the light at the end of the tunnel. All the celebrities sort of get on well. So we're all really looking forward to it.
The way you cast Celebrity Big Brother is very different from the way you cast Big Brother. Somebody would have said, this is Shil Pashetti, she's a massive Bollywood star. Great, we need some bloody celebrities. Here's a different kind of celebrity. Let's have her. In the previous Celebrity Big Brother, we'd put Chantel in the Big Brother house.
From now on, you are a pop star. That's all right with me.
So we thought, what would be an interesting take on that sort of slightly postmodern celebrity thing? Who's the queen of Big Brother? It's Jade. She's become a celebrity through Big Brother. Wouldn't it be interesting to see how she interacts with people who regard themselves as proper celebrities?
Despite Leo Sayer getting aerated, the series began well.
I don't want the fee. I want to go back to Australia. I want to leave this fucking stupid country and get the hell out of here.
And the producers waited for a big storyline to open up. And it did.
I'm just fed up of fucking having to eat when she wants to eat and...
Yeah.
She has to cook everything. She's fucking doing my head in.
It was kind of a pack mentality. It was like one person said something and it was almost like the bitchy floodgates were open.
I just don't get why you're bleaching your nose.
I can't believe she does her makeup in the toilet, all discreet, but walks out with that on her face.
Yeah, Big Brother is the ultimate honesty format. It's like it's dipping you in acid as a person. You can't hide anything. You are stripped to your bare essentials. Your personality is exposed.